Hey there, my name's Drew Brashler, and in this video, I'm going to be teaching you how to do multi-track recording with your Behringer XR18, which is the XR and MR series mixers. Now, if you're brand new to my channel, I'm all about helping you feel more confident in your production gear no matter where you're starting from. So let's go ahead and dive in. Now, the Behringer XR18 and the Midas MR18 have a USB interface built into the front of the board. So all you have to do is get a USB B cable, which is more of the printer style cable, and have that connect into your computer, and then you can get your audio from your XR18 or MR18 into your computer. Now, when you have that cable and connect it into your computer, what you have to do is if you are on a Mac, it'll automatically work with Core Audio. Now, if you're on a PC, you will need to download the Behringer driver for the audio, which you can find at behringer.com. And once you have the drivers downloaded, the next thing that you need to do is have a DAW, or a digital audio workstation. Now, a DAW is a digital audio workstation. Now, I have Reaper installed on my computer, but it could also be Logic Pro, it could be Studio One, it could be Cubase, it could be Pro Tools, any DAW program that you have installed on your computer that can accept multiple inputs. For instance, our XR18 has 16 inputs on the front of the board. So I'm wanting to have 16 channels of multi-track audio going into my computer. So I have my XR edit here, which we can see that I have a bunch of channels here. And then I have my DAW. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just go ahead and create 16 channels of audio. So here is 16 channels that I have on my DAW here. Now the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go into my options and make sure that my audio device for my DAW is set to the X18, XR18, or the MR18 if you have the Midas version. And then I'm going to press OK. Now at this point, what I want to do is I want to route my channels to these tracks. So I'm going to go into View and then go into my routing matrix. And then here, I can define what channels are being sent to what tracks. So I have my input 1, I'm wanting to have that on track 1. And I'm going to go to input 2, and I'm going to have that go to track 2. And I'm just going to go ahead and do this all the way down. Now, if you have a stereo channel that you want to have recorded into a track as a stereo track, so for instance, 15 and 16, what I can do is I can go down into my input 15 stereo. And if I go ahead and select that for my track 15, what that's going to do is that's going to take input 15 plus 16 to record to this stereo track. But I'm not doing that today, so I'm just going to go ahead and select 15 and 16. At this point, I'm going to go ahead and hide my routing matrix. I'm going to go ahead and press select all, and I'm going to record arm these tracks. Now that I have these tracks set up as record arm, what I need to do is I need to hop back over to my XR edit, and I need to verify my routing that I have. So I'm going to go to in out, and I'm going to go to my USB sends. Now there are a couple different options that we have selected that we can do for each of our USB sends. So when we have the in out tab and USB sends selected, this is going to be what actually goes out of our USB audio interface to our DAW. So the output of the USB goes into the input of our DAW. I know that that's a lot kind of to understand, but basically what we set in our USB sends is what the DAW accepts as audio. So we see that we have all of our 16 channels of the mixer. We have our aux ins, we have our effects returns. We then have our 6 aux buses, and then our 4 effects sends, and then our main left right. So for us, what we're wanting to do is we are wanting to set this up for a virtual sound check, which I'm going to have another video here shortly about how to actually get this audio to play back into our mixer to be able to practice mixing. But when we're recording this audio, we want to have it unprocessed, meaning that I don't want my gate, my EQ, my dynamics, any of that to be affecting the audio that's being recorded. So to do that, what we want to have this set on is analog. And what we can do is we can go down to default signal tab, and we can set this to analog, and then we can go and select all of our channels. Now, as we can see, this is already routed, but say this is kind of messed up here. What we would want to do is we would want to route channel 1 to USB 1, and we want to go down and make sure that all of these are set accordingly. Now, if you are wanting to record with processing, then what you would want to do is you'd want to go down to pre-fader, and then this is going to then record our channels post-processing. So we can see that this is kind of a purple look to it. Now, if you wanted to include the fader movements that you're doing, then you would want to go and select post fader, and then you can go down and select all of these going down. But in this case, again, I don't want that post-processing affecting the audio. That way I can practice with this audio later. So I'm going to go set this to analog and go all the way down. Now, if you are utilizing any USB inputs for your channels, say you're using your DAW to play backing tracks, but you also want to record those backing tracks, what you would need to do is you would need to right-click and go and select input, because input allows us to take the USB or the analog in, whereas analog is literally just the input to our mixer here. Now, once we have that set, we want to go to our channels and set our channel gain. And as we can see, this kick drum is pretty hot. In fact, in my DAW, I've already clipped this. So what we want to do is we want to set our channel gains so that we are hitting that nominal gain of about negative 18, negative 20 mark, and that we're not clipping any of our channels. So this is where you need to go through channel by channel and make sure that your gain is set correctly. Now, at this point, what we can do is we can go back to our DAW and we can go ahead and press record. And as we can see that our audio is being recorded here. Now, my recommendation is to record a rehearsal and then be able to take that audio and play it back through your mixer and through your PA to practice with those tracks. And again, I have a video coming out on the virtual sound check for the Behringer XR18. Now, once we are finished recording, we can go ahead and press stop down in the bottom. And as we can see, we want to save all, and we can see that all of our audio is here. In fact, I can go ahead and select all of these, and I can press the record off, and then if I wanted to, I could go ahead and press play and have this audio start playing back. Now, I would need to change the routing for my mixer to get that audio playing back into my mixer, which again is on the virtual soundcheck video. Now, one tip that I have is if you are only using the XLR ins and that you're not using the aux input on the front of the XR18, is to route your left-right mix into the USB sends. So when we go back to our input-output and go to USB sends, instead of having 17 and 18 set to aux in left and right, have this set to main left and right, and you can even go and set this to post fader, and that way you can get all of your adjustments for your fader of the master fader and all of the actual mix that you're creating for that show. And you can record not only the multi-track files of the 16 inputs, but then also a post mix of your left-right fader. Now, I hope this video was helpful for you. If you do happen to have any questions, or if there's a video that you're hoping that I would make on the XR18 or really any of the other production mixers that are out there, please post that in the comment section down below, as I'm always reading through those comments to find videos that are going to be helpful for you. If you haven't already, make sure to check out my website at drewbrashler.com, where I just launched a brand new XR18 or XR and MR series mixers course. So it's a full video course that you can learn all that there is to learn about the XR18, the MR18, or any of those mixers in that series. Now, if you want to go check that out, there is a link in the description, or you can go over to drewbrashler.com and find that on my site. Otherwise, I hope you guys have a great day.